Manual handling to me means getting an object from A to B, whether that's lifting it, lowering it, pushing it or pulling it.
It can be as simple as moving your water bottle on your desk, bringing your laptop out of your bag, or it can be as big as moving a 2-ton box within a warehouse.
Manual handling for me is a set of rules how to lift bags, equipment or some heavy stuff safely.
It's interaction with something else that causes your body to be in a little bit of discomfort if not done properly.
The most common ones that we see and hear of all the time are lower back injuries.
You lean over to pick something up and you pull a muscle in your back.
I injured my back really badly. I wasn't warmed up properly during my work.
Hand injuries is a common one. Also, if you look at climbing as manual handling or part of manual handling, a lot of strains.
The twisting and turning injuries, maybe back or arm strains.
I would say it's because the technique around the movement isn't considered. When you're lifting something big and heavy, you're going to consider how you lift that object. But when it comes to you being in an awkward position and you're simply lifting up a spanner, you're just going to reach for it and lift it because you don't perceive that object as being heavy.
And wind farms were so exposed to the elements, ice, rain, snow, heat as well, can lead to injuries.
Working offshore is much more extreme. Wind is really strong, visibility could be bad. So all this can affect your manual handling.
I personally have had time off work because of being in a coal turbine, just standing there for hours on end, just rigid, trying to keep warm, and my back just seized up.
Injuries can impact people in a multiple different ways. If you hurt your back at work, there's a high chance that when you go home, you're not going to be able to lift your kid up, or you're not going to be able to go and do that sport that you like to do.
It's a very physical job that you're doing, so any type of injury takes you out of doing that. That might impact pay, family life.
People maybe don't consider a manual handling injury might have a mental health impact, but it can do when it has that knock-on effect on your colleagues, your family members, your own well-being when you're having to take that time off from work as well.
You do get a feeling of guilt if you have to be off work, meanwhile your colleagues are having to pick up the slack.
I have suffered many injuries as a result of downhill mountain biking. I had my career come to an end because I shattered my pelvis. It affected my mental health massively, going from being very physically able to having to manage pain, and affected my personal relationships. It affected the amount of money I earned at that time in my life. It put me in a bad place.
If I'm approaching a manual handling task, I'll look at the risk assessment, the type of work that we're doing, any kind of mechanical aids that we have to help us, looking to see the work party, if there's two or three of us, if we can attempt it together.
After this accident, when I approach some manual handling task, I always remember about manual handling rules. And if I need help, I always ask my colleague.
My personal process is just to stop and play it through in my head exactly how I'm going to complete the task. Do I have any lifting aids? Can I pop it on a trolley and push it somewhere?
A tool that I'd use to consider a manual handling task is the tile method, which is your task, the individual, the load, and the environment. And if you go through it in that order, you'll often come to a very low risk solution to what you need to carry out. Manual handling is everybody's responsibility, and it's important for anybody within the team to speak up if they think something isn't quite right.
And also it's the employer's responsibility to make sure you have the right methods of working, the right risk assessments, and the right training and competency to make sure that you're safely manual handling.
All of us are responsible for manual handling.
The organisation can instill as much knowledge as possible into every individual and try and create that culture, but ultimately it's the individual at the end of the day looking after themselves.
My top tip when you have to employ manual handling techniques is actually to consider what do you want to be doing later at home that's important to you.
Remember, always keep safe, don't rush, work carefully, and never forget about your safety.
Stop and just think things through before you do it. Don't make a rushed decision just to get a job done quick.
Don't let time pressures lead to bad behaviours.
Work within the rules, make sure you're using the right equipment, your equipment's in date, you've limbered up, you've done your stretches, just be safe and think ahead.
Yeah, let's all work to live and not live to work.